everyone, this is 5th November 2017 Sunday. You all are listening to the newspaper highlights on adavaneng.com. Let's see the important news from the Sunday Times. The main news says Rs 10.5 billion bond windfall remains frozen with CB. Perpetual Treasuries Limited's true bank account amounting Rs 10.5 billion containing its profit from the questionable bond transaction will remain frozen till January 2018 after the Supreme Court this week rejected PTL's fundamental rights petition challenging the Monetary Board's suspension of its primary dealer's license and the blocking of its account. The middle news says petrol crisis. CPC makes emergency purchase in spot market. The Ceylon Petroleum Corporation went into making emergency purchase in the spot market as the country was crippled without fuel and rationing introduced until the situation was normalized. Next to that, let's see the news highlights from Sunday Observer. The main news of Sunday Observer says Gita judgment to rock parliament. The five-judge bench headed by Chief Justice Priyadas Deb upheld the May 3 Court of Appeal decision to remove film star turned politician because she was disqualified to be a candidate as she also held citizenship of Switzerland. The middle news says industrialization of Rohuna. PM opens Sinolanga trade office. Industrialization of Rohuna through Hambantota Free Trade Zone will begin to materialize with the opening of the office to streamline Sri Lanka-China Free Trade Complex, said Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe. And the bottom news says many JO members keen to join SLFP. WDJ Senavaratna says a large number of SLFP members in the joint opposition are keen to contest with the SLFP at the upcoming local government and provincial council election. SLFP Senior Vice President and Labour and Trade Union Relation Minister WDJ Senavaratna said. Finally, let's see the important news from Ceylon Today. The main news of Ceylon Today says Auditor General wants NAC scrapped. Auditor General Gamani Vijayasinghe has written to President Maithripala Sirisena and Speaker Karu Jayasuriya last Wednesday requesting them to do away the National Audit Commission which was established under the 19th Amendment to the Constitution, sources said. Another important news says, Suresh Premachandran says he will not support ITAK anymore. Leader of the Elam People's Revolutionary Liberation Front, Suresh Premachandran, yesterday announced that he has pulled out his party from Ilangai Tamil Arasu Katchi, the main constituent party of the Tamil National Alliance, because ITAK had betrayed the Tamil people by backing the constitutional proposal that do not meet the people's demands. The middle news says new bribery laws soon. School donations punishable. Donations procured by schools will be considered bribes when the new bribery laws are introduced, said Director General of the Commission to Investigate Allegations of Bribery or Corruption, Sarath Jayamanne. With that news, let's off the news highlights of today. I'll get back to you with more news tomorrow.